why 700 stars have mysteriously disappeared. From what is apparently happening out in space to what we're doing to try and figure everything out and more, join us as we reveal to you why 700 stars have mysteriously vanished. There are a few things in this world that are meant to be constant or fully knowable. After all, it took us many thousands of years to get a grasp on things like science and math to help us understand our place in the universe and what that place, meaning Earth, is about at its core, even though we technically don't know what's inside the core. One of these principal beliefs is that of the states of matter. If you don't know, it's the understanding that matter can't just be destroyed. Something has to happen to it for it to go away. For example, if you were to take a dip into lava, your body would vanish, but only because the state of its matter has been shifted. It's not gone, it's just in an entirely different state. Or like how a planet explodes and it's gone, but its matter is still out there, it's just scattered across the stars. The reason we bring this up is that there's a bit of a mystery going on in the depths of outer space that honestly doesn't have a clear answer as of yet. What is that mystery? Stars are disappearing from the sky. At first, this might not seem like a big deal, mainly because in the grand scope of the universe, the idea of a star going away suddenly is possible given certain factors, just as how it reached the end of its life or it's been absorbed by a black hole or something equally grand. The problem here is that the stars in question aren't singular, they're numerous. Just in recent measurements, there appears to be over 700 stars missing, and there's no clue as to how they suddenly blinked out of existence. A handful of stars vanishing can be explained across a large universe, but hundreds in a short period of time? Ones that weren't near their ending life points or had objects that were trying to destroy the stars? Yeah, that's a different thing entirely. Thankfully, there are some people who are trying to figure this out. VASCO is the Vanishing and Appearing Sources During a Century of Observations project, said Beatrice Villarroel of the Nordic Institute for Theoretical Physics in Sweden. We're actually interested in all kinds of vanishing objects, but ideally, I'd like to find a star that's been steady and has been there in the sky for as long as we can remember and as long as we have data for, and one day it just vanishes. And you can point the biggest telescopes in the world at it and still see nothing there. Lest you think that this is just a random group of people trying to find something fun to do. They've been doing this since 2017 and they've gotten a lot of attention for it. We have astronomers from all kinds of different fields interested in the project, specialists in active galactic nuclei, the power source of intensely brilliant quasars in the distant universe, stellar physicists, and SETI, search for extraterrestrial intelligence scientists. Everyone has their reasons for getting involved. The team in question know that there are things out there that we can't fully predict, as it would be impossible to fully catalog what is going on with every star or object in space with 100% accuracy given our distance from them. But they're confident that if we find the right kind of star going out from the sky, we'll learn something new. We know that there are variables, but their timescales tend to be a few years at most. We want to find something that goes from a completely steady star to just vanishing entirely. This hasn't been documented, and it's the kind of discovery that would lead to new physics. But you might be thinking, can you really show that a star just blinks out of existence randomly? Yes, we can. For example, there was one star in 2019 that had been studied by astronomers for quite some time, 2 decades in fact. They were attracted to the star partly because of how it shined with a crystal blue hue, and then randomly it was gone. Andrew Allen, a doctoral student in astrophysics at Trinity College Dublin, checked and rechecked the data. The star was too far away for telescopes to spot it directly, so astronomers looked for the distinct signatures that these luminous blue stars imprint on the light coming from their home galaxy. But those traces have vanished. The likely explanation at the time was that of it going supernova and then turning into a black hole. But not only was there no sign of a supernova or what it would bring, there was no black hole that could be noticed either. And given the time between sightings, it was very unlikely that they didn't notice it. If indeed the star turned into a black hole with no supernova at all, then it's a case of gone without a bang that astronomers have been searching for a while now, Iyer Arkavi, an astronomer at Tel Aviv University, noted. The theory that Iyer noted was that there is a potential for a star to simply go from dying to a black hole without it bursting into a bright and massive supernova. There have been indications of this being possible back in 2009, when a star that was in the sights of many telescopes seemed to be getting ready for a bang and then suddenly was a black hole before they realized it. While they couldn't definitively prove that's what happened, it was an oddity that could not be immediately explained, and that's a huge deal. Just as important, though, is that many teams, including ones that we talked about already, have been working on getting catalogs of stars in their charts so that they can view them online alongside others and then compare the data enough to see what is going on. And the results have been both promising and shocking. We have found a number of short-lived transients that appear on one image and then not again. Those account for most of what we found so far, but there are other things that we're not sure of what they are yet. We studied some of these short-lived transients, and they don't seem to be M-dwarf flares, the huge outbursts caused by the tangled magnetic fields of faint red dwarfs that may cause them to brighten by a factor of 100 or more, or any type of supernova. I think we can start excluding those options. Following up on that, there is a common belief that has been difficult to prove across some astronomers that the reason some of these stars are blinking out is because of how light reaches us across the universe. Think of it like this. Imagine a light in your room. Now imagine walking in a straight line away from it until it's gone from your view. Now multiply that distance across galaxies. Makes you wonder how we see anything at all, right? The answer to that is because the various light rays from these stars take a long time to travel here, and even when they get here, they mix with the rays of our sun to become more visible in our night sky. The light we're seeing is many, many years old. In terms of our own sun, we see it brightly every day because it's constantly pumping out light to reach us and warm us up. But even though it's close, those rays take about 8 minutes to get to Earth. So now multiply that by light years and you see how old those stars' light is. Why does that matter here? Simply because the light is so old, it's possible that we see it blink out immediately. Because to us it looks that way, but for the star it's been gone for a while, and we're just realizing it's gone. This also feeds into the notion of stars sometimes going bright for a very large period and then going dim in a way that we can't see them anymore because of it. It's very complex, and obviously it's unproven, but these questions are ones that need to be asked in order to potentially find out the truth about what's going on here. Of course, there are those who always like to look at the nuclear option in terms of these theories, and for astronomers, the nuclear option for disappearing stars is that of aliens. But how can aliens make stars blink out, you might be asking? Well, it's not so much that they're blinking out, but rather that they're containing them for their own measures. Tell us, have you ever heard of a Dyson sphere? A Dyson sphere is an object of science fiction, for now, that is said to be when alien civilizations, or Earth in very rare circumstances, are able to literally contain the sun in a special device that grants them energy and power. In other words, they turn the sun into a battery or a weapon. If you're a fan of Star Wars, you'll recall that in The Force Awakens, the Starkiller base drained the power of the star to destroy several planets of the Republic. It's the same principle. So here, that would mean that the stars have been contained in part or in whole to the extent that their light can't reach Earth anymore. The reasons for this feat being hard to fathom as a logical explanation is manifold, not the least of which is that aliens haven't been proven to exist yet. But even if they were, the technology and time it would take to build a fully functional Dyson sphere, even around a small star, would take an incredible amount of time. And when you realize that doing this across 700 plus stars would be a literal galactic undertaking, it seems incredibly unlikely. Does that stop people from believing in it? Not a chance. So where does that leave us? The answer is, without answers. We know that something is happening out in space to where stars are vanishing from our charts and our sight. The question is, why and how? We know that this can't be a fluke with one or two stars, as we have found multitudes of them missing. But then the question goes back to what is going on to cause so many to vanish within a short period of time. This is why so many people across so many groups are trying to figure this out. Because if they're able to answer these questions, it could give us a greater understanding of our universe. To the extent that when this potentially happens again, we could more quickly answer what's going on. Furthermore, it might answer questions of the past, like with the 2009 star incident, or the one from more recently in 2019 that seemed to blink out. Stars are, by and large, one of the most important things we study in our universe, so learning what is going on with them is vital on a grand scale. We may not know what's happening right now, but that doesn't mean we won't know given enough time. Thanks for watching, everyone. What did you think of this look at the mysterious things going on out in outer space and how stars are apparently disappearing without a trace? Do you think that there's a logical explanation for all that's going on out in space? Or is there something that we just don't know about that is causing all the stars to blink out of sight? Let us know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and we'll see you next time on the channel.